Hey everyone, Aaron Davis from SCP Euro, and today I'm going to be talking about the EA888 Gen 2 2.0T engine. So today we're going to be talking about the EA888 Gen 2 2.0T engine. This engine is actually found in a handful of Audis such as A4, A5, Q5, and more models. This 2-liter is found in roughly between 2009 to 2016, especially for the A4s. The Audi Q5 behind me is a 2017, but the 2-liter was not introduced to the Q5 platform until 2011. So in this video, I'm going to be going over the problematic issues that can happen with this 2.0T engine and also give you tips on how to diagnose it. So let's go head over to the car. I'm going to point things out because it's going to be a lot easier. So let's go look. So now we're at the engine. I'm going to take off the engine cover. I'm going to work my way from the driver's side to the passenger side. I'm going to point things out that may be problematic with this car and also give you some information on what's actually inside your engine bay. So I'm going to go ahead. You just pull up on the four corners. Take the engine cover off. All right, so now we're looking at the driver's side. The first thing you're probably going to notice is this module right here. This module right here is actually your ABS, so if you are ever looking for your ABS module, this is it. This is what controls your brakes. Right next to it is your coolant reservoir. As you can see, the coolant on these Audis are pink. They're G13. You always want to put G13 in this. You don't want to put any other color from like Peak or anything like that, so always put G13 in it. Speaking of coolant, one of the problematic things for this 2.0T engine is actually the water pump. The water pump is actually located right underneath your intake manifold. So the issues with this water pump, you can have a check engine light come on. You can have faults for cooling system performance, which means something electronically with the water pump is failing that you might want to take a look at. There is a sensor you do have to plug in. Now also, speaking of water pump failures, not from electronically, we're going to talk about the coolant leaks from it. You can have coolant leaks from the water pump, from the thermostat housing itself, the water pump gasket, and also the gasket for the water pump that actually bolts to the block. One of the biggest culprits for going through water pumps a lot is actually an oil leak coming from the cylinder head cover, which will make oil leak from the cylinder cover make its way to the block and swell that gasket, which means there will be a coolant leak from that as well. So that's also another issue you want to look at for your water pump failing is actually an oil leak, not coolant. So I just mentioned that the water pump is actually underneath the intake manifold, but actually let's talk about the intake manifold for this engine. So the earlier 2.0T engines with the EA888 Gen 2 motor in it, engine code CAEB, had a plastic intake manifold, which had a lot of failure points from the diaphragm rod popping out and also the runner failures. So as you can see for this Q5, the Q5 is actually equipped with a flex fuel engine, which is CPMA or CPMB engine codes, which shows a metal intake manifold, but there is still plastic runners underneath the intake manifold. And the reason why they use this metal intake manifold is because there's actually a fifth injector for cold starting, which makes the car start up much easier. And also this engine can run more ethanol compared to regular gas engines. So underneath the intake manifold, the fuel rail is there, which holds the four fuel injectors. Now, if you find yourself having the same misfire in the same cylinder, say for example, you're having misfires on cylinder 3, you replace your spark plug and coil pack and it's still there. A thing that you might want to look at is your fuel injectors as well. And also when I do fuel injector replacements, I do all four because you don't want to do all that work and go back in. You have to replace the remainder of the fuel injectors. Now with talking about fuel injectors, this 2.0T engine is direct injection, which means it is notorious for carbon buildup. So which that means is no fuel actually gets sprayed onto the intake valves, what multiport does. So you can get misfires from carbon buildup on the valves as well. So during the ownership of this 2.0T engine, you will have to do a carbon cleaning on this as well. And I would start looking at that every 60,000 miles. So I already mentioned one oil leak that actually can happen from the cylinder head cover itself, but another oil leak that can happen is oil actually leaking into the spark plug. So that happens because over time the RTV in it gives out and allows oil to seep in. And you'll notice that this 2-liter does not actually have a valve cover gasket like the normal 2-liters for like the Gen 1 do. This one uses RTV with no gasket and only relies on that. So you also want to just check that, make sure there's no oil leaking into your spark plug. That's easy. You can pull your coil pack and spark plug out and then you can see how oil soaked they are. And also oil leaking can come from the outside of the cylinder head cover too. So if you see any seepage, that may be a good indicator to actually go ahead and reseal your cylinder head cover. Luckily, we do have a DIY on how to do that. This car actually only has 65,000 miles, and while I pulled the spark plug out, I saw that it was oil soaked and the RTV had to be resealed. So now that I talked to you about leaks that can actually come from the cylinder head cover, let's talk about what's on the cylinder head cover. The first thing you're gonna notice is this system right here. This is actually your breather system. You can actually have a check engine light come on for this for your vehicle running lean at idle, because the diaphragm inside of this tends to rip. And you can also tell if it rips, because when it does happen, you're gonna get a really annoying whistling coming out of this check valve. So if you hear that whistling, like, go ahead and put your finger on it and that noise will go away. And that's a really good indicator that this diaphragm inside of this is actually torn and you have to go ahead and replace it. And also, this allows crankcase gases to pass through the engine. So if it does pass through, you may find yourself having some type of oil consumption issue. So the easiest thing to replace first is obviously the breather. So this is a common replacement also for oil consumption on this engine. So now that I've talked to you about the breather system, you're gonna go ahead and look right behind. This is actually your high pressure fuel pump. There's not really a common failure on this high pressure fuel pump compared to like the earlier 2.0T engines when they had that cam bucket that would actually be pushed through and worn through and actually do damage to the actual camshaft. This one actually has a nice wheel that rides on the camshaft, so Audi fixed that issue. Also, what's plugged into the high pressure fuel pump is your vacuum pump. Not a ton of issues with the vacuum pump as well. I've never really had to replace it, but there is a gasket. So sometimes you may find yourself with an oil leak, and that just means you have to actually replace your vacuum pump gasket. Now, you'll also see on top of the cylinder head cover are four coil packs, and underneath your coil packs are your spark plugs. With this 2.0T engine, you may get check engine lights for P0300 for multiple misfires, P0301 for cylinder one misfire, all the way to four. The really common to replace is the spark plugs and coil packs as a whole. I like to do them all together, just gets rid of the issue right away. Because once one fails, it's bound for the others to just follow right behind it. And as you can see, they're right on top. They're very easy on how to replace it. And in my DIYs, you see how I take them off and actually put in the new ones as well. So the spark plugs actually do have a service interval. You want to replace them every 35K. That's what I like to do. That's what Audi calls for. The coil packs do not have a service interval. They're more of a replace when they do fail. I would start looking at replacing the coil packs from 50,000 to 75,000 miles, but don't quote me on that. Just make sure you keep an eye on the coil packs. So we're gonna make our way to the front of the cylinder head cover, and right here you're gonna see your upper timing chain cover. This 2 liter may have some timing issues because the chain stretches over time, and also everyone knows about this 2.0T. If you haven't read about it, the tensioners like to fail on them. So Audi did come up with an updated tensioner to fix that, but from what I've seen, it does fix it to some degree, but when you own this car, you're probably bound to do a timing chain and tensioner. And also a good indicator on when to actually start looking at your timing is you're gonna get a check engine light on for the P0016. That means cam crank correlation's off. So that means the ECM is saying that the crank and cams are not timed together. So as soon as you have that fault, I would turn the vehicle off and I would definitely start doing a timing repair. I do have a DIY on that. It's pretty complicated, but I hope that DIY helps you out a lot if you do own this car and you have to do it, and I hope it could save you some money. So now I'll talk to you about the cylinder head cover. You can see right here, your oil filter is right on top. Audi actually invented this engine to suck oil out rather than drain it from the bottom, but of course there still is an oil drain plug, so you can still do it the traditional way. But in the dealerships, they suck it out, take the filter out. Underneath that, you're gonna see your alternator right here. This is your Serpentine belt, or also known as accessory belt. The service interval on that is around every 75,000 miles, but you also want to keep a look on your belt and make sure there's no cracking or drying on that, because you don't want that to go, because as soon as that goes, so does your accessories. So fun fact, the T in the 2.0T does stand for turbocharged. That means that this 2 liter is turbocharged. So underneath right here, these are the Audi valve lift solenoids. This is the turbocharger heat shield, and right underneath that heat shield is the turbocharger. So during the ownership of this 2.0T engine, you may actually see turbocharger failure, and you'll have fault codes for turbocharger boost faults. So now, usually this means that the wastegate actually becomes loose. There was a TSV to put a clip on top of the wastegate to actually fix that rattle, but what we found in the dealership is that only lasted 10,000 miles and the car would come back. It'd be rattling more than ever. So we always had to replace the turbocharger. But before you do that, one of the key factors you do want to look at is actually the diverter valve, because the diverter valve diaphragm can actually rip, which can actually cause those faults as well. Also, just for a cheaper option for a process of elimination, you can always just throw in a brand new OE diverter valve, clear the faults, drive it again. If the fault does come back, I would definitely look at into replacing a turbocharger. I do have a turbocharger DIY. It is a pretty tough job, but all the steps are there so you can learn how to do it yourself at your house. And now you're probably gonna see this crazy piping right here. This is actually your air intake. This is your MAF sensor. And then this is a little air duct that allows air to come in, go through the air filter, and it actually feeds it to the turbocharger. All right, so actually underneath the turbocharger, there is an engine mount. These engine mounts are known to fail because the rubber in themselves actually rip. When these rubbers rip, you'll actually see this purple goo, which is also an indicator that it's time to replace your engine mount. And you're also gonna see that they are electronically controlled, but a fun fact, if electronic faults from your engine mount do occur, you will not get a check engine light on. So that's something you have to keep an eye out with a scanner to actually see if you do have faults for these. So that about wraps it up for the EA888 Gen 2 2.0T engine. I hope this video got you a little bit more familiar with the ownership of this 2.0T engine and also showed you basic layouts of this engine as well. If you liked the video, don't forget to like, subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment box below. And as always, I'll see you soon.